జై జై శ్రీ దర్శన. లెట్స్ లిసన్ టు మాలోలన్స్ మిరాకిల్ దట్ కంటిన్యూడ్ విత్ శ్రీ ఆదివన్ సడగోప యతీంద్ర జీయర్. సూన్ ఆఫ్టర్ లీవింగ్ తిరుక్కురుగూర్, షడగోప జీయర్ జర్నీ టు ద ఈస్ట్ టువర్డ్స్ ఒరిసా. వన్ మార్నింగ్ కింగ్ ముకుంద దేవరాయ ఆఫ్ ఒరిసా కేమ్ టు మీట్ ద జీయర్. He fell at the feet of the Jeer and said, "Swami, I am distressed with a big problem. Muslim invaders have usurped my kingdom. Lord Narasimha appeared in my dream and ordered me to take refuge under you. You alone can protect me. Please help me." The Jeer blessed the king and accepted the king as his disciple. Then he said, "Do not worry. Malolan has shown you the path. He will look after you." A few days later, the Muslim ruler, his minister and his army had the same dream of lions pouncing on them. The Muslim ruler rushed to Mukunda Devaraya and begged, "Please take back your kingdom. We do not want it anymore." The next morning, King Mukunda Devaraya visited Shadagopa Jeer and fell at his feet. He said, "Swami, it is only by Sri Malolan and your mercy that I have regained my lost kingdom. In gratitude, please accept my humble offerings." The king offered royal umbrellas, hand fans and 18 types of musical instruments as gifts. He also gifted elephants, horses and a new ivory palanquin to the Jeer. He appealed to the Jeer to sit in the palanquin. Then the king himself carried the palanquin in a procession around the streets of his kingdom. Furthermore, traveling across the country, Adivan Shadagopa Jeer returned to his birthplace, that is Thirunarayanapuram. The village folk gave him a pompous and hearty welcome. The Jeer continued to receive many disciples. Once, the Jeer was giving a special lecture on Swami Ramanuja's magnum opus work, Sri Bhashyam. Among the disciples, a serpent with 5 hoods also decided to attend the discourse. The serpent appeared to be listening intently to Sri Bhashyam, hanging on to every word of the Jeer. After the completion of a particular chapter, the Jeer said, "This is no ordinary serpent. He is not harming anyone. He is listening with rapt attention, swaying his jewel-decked hoods. He must be Swami Ramanuja himself, the avatar of Adisesha. He is here to listen to the deeper meanings of his own work and bless us." The Jeer turned to the serpent and recited a verse in praise of Swami Ramanuja. Lo and behold, as soon as he uttered the shloka's last syllable, the 5-headed serpent disappeared. That night, Swami Ramanuja appeared in the Jeer's dream and said, "I enjoyed your lecture on Sri Bhashyam. There is an important kaingaryam, that is service, needed in the temple here that I would like you to fulfill." The Jeer woke up and wondered, what could this special kaingaryam be? Let's wait and watch.